Ja, schönen guten Abend, meine sehr geehrten Damen und Herren. Ich möchte Sie ganz herzlich begrüßen zum 23. Afrika Live Festival. Wir haben dieses Jahr so einen kleinen Schwerpunkt Migration und Flucht. Das ist ein Thema, was in Afrika eigentlich immer schon präsent war und was wir auch immer wieder hier bei uns im Kino behandelt haben, also bei Afrika Live insbesondere, und nicht nur die Flucht und Migration nach Europa, sondern auch die innerafrikanische Flucht, Migration, die ja auch einen großen Bereich irgendwie umfasst. Und genau, aber es ist ein Thema, was irgendwie nach wie vor, auch wenn es letztes Jahr sehr viel darüber gesprochen worden ist und sehr viel, es ist nach wie vor aktuell. Und deswegen auch sehr wichtig. Gerade gestern ging ja wieder die Nachricht rum, dass in Libyen neue Auffanglager geschaffen werden sollen. Und ja, von daher ist dieses Thema uns hier ein sehr besonderes Anliegen. Was uns auch sozusagen insbesondere wichtig bei den Filmen war, die wir dieses Jahr hier zeigen, das war gestern der Les Sauteurs, Those Who Jump, und eben heute Peter Hellers Film und Salyusar Films Saraba. Dass es eben auch so einen Perspektivwechsel gibt, dass die beiden Filme einen anderen Blick auf Migration und einen neuen Blick auf Migration eröffnen, eben indem sie gestern in dem Film tatsächlich die Kamera selbst in die Hand nehmen und ihre Situation filmen. Und auch der Film heute Abend ist sehr, sehr nah dran an den Protagonisten. Es sind sozusagen die Cousins von Salyusar, die er über 8 Jahre lang begleitet. Ja, und von daher kriegt man dann nochmal einen anderen Blick auf die Situation. Genau, ich freue mich sehr, dass wir heute Abend Salyusar und Peter Heller zu Gast haben, die ich hier sehr, sehr herzlich begrüßen möchte. Ja. Peter Heller ist unabhängiger Filmemacher, Produzent, Autor, der seit vielen, vielen Jahren Filme macht, auch sehr viel zum Thema Afrika, aber nicht nur, sondern sich auch allgemein mit gesellschaftlichen Problemen auseinandersetzt. Vielleicht nur ein paar seiner Filme, Das Brot des Siegers von 1988, Assikel, Die Reise über die Tuaregs von 1990, Platten in Umtata von 2007, Colonial Mama und der letzte, wie große Film, der auch hier in den Kinos lief, Süßes Gift von 2012. Salyusar ist Musiker, Schauspieler, erst vom Theater, aber auch Filmschauspieler und hat dann eben jetzt auch seinen ersten Film gedreht. Er stammt auch aus dem Ort Niodor, den wir gleich hier auf der Leinwand sehen werden. Er hatte jedoch die Möglichkeit, in Dakar auf die Schule zu gehen, aber er war immer jeden Sommer oder sehr viel Zeit hat er in Niodor zusammen mit seinen Cousins verbracht und deswegen war ihm auch diese Geschichte sehr, sehr wichtig. Ja, vielleicht soweit für jetzt und im Anschluss gibt es die Möglichkeit zur Diskussion. Und nach der Diskussion werden wir noch ein kleines, weil wie gesagt, er ist Musiker, begleitet auch im Film, den Film sehr stark mit seiner Musik, irgendwie mit seinen Gesang, seinen Liedern. Und es gibt dann oben noch die Möglichkeit einer kleinen Musikperformance. Und noch ein weiterer Hinweis, es gibt ein Kamerateam hier, die auch nachher bei der Diskussion filmen werden, nur dass Sie Bescheid wissen, falls es irgendwelche Einwände gibt und Sie nicht gefilmt werden wollen. Und die Diskussion im Anschluss würden wir gerne auf Englisch führen, weil es einfacher wäre für uns und auch direkter wäre dann mit dem Austausch. Ich hoffe, es gibt keine Probleme, sonst sagen Sie bitte Bescheid, dann würden wir übersetzen lassen. Okay, gut, soweit erstmal. Dann wünsche ich jetzt erstmal viel Spaß beim Film. Also da möchte ich nochmal ganz, ganz herzlich Salyusar und Peter Heller hier begrüßen. Genau, und dann nochmal die Ankündigung, dass so ungefähr 20 nach 8 draußen eben nochmal eine kleine Musikperformance gibt. But okay, now to the film. And yeah, maybe I start with the first question. The film stops around 1 year ago. And in the meantime, some developments have been acute. Maybe you can tell us about some good news which have been happened some t- time ago now, some weeks ago.
Okay, so first of all, I would like to thanks everybody. Thanks Africa Life Festival for this occasion. Thank everybody who came to watch this film. So in the meantime, my cousin Alaji finally got his papers. So now he's planning to come back to Senegal. We are planning to shoot his return to Senegal. And maybe it's going to be in this next month. So these are the news. Thank you.
Okay. So, but okay, now we go back a little bit again to the beginning of the film. So how did this project started? And of course, when you started this project, was the idea? And you, of course, you couldn't foresee the development the film would take, the long time it would take. And so maybe you can tell us a little bit about the beginning of the project.
Okay, the project started in a workshop I was doing in Dakar, organized by the Goethe Institute. That's where I met Mr. Peter Heller, because I did not do documentary studies, I did sociology, but I was interested in filming and I started applying for different workshops. That's how I did the first workshop with Africa Doc and a second with the Goethe Institute, and I met Peter Heller. And then we talked, something like friendship started, and then I told him about my story, the story of my family, my cousins, my brothers, my dad. And then we had this idea to follow maybe this story, but we did not know, of course, that it would take 8 years. So we had to be patient. And I think that's one of the first lessons I had from this film, like patience, take time and follow things, take time. And then after, by the way, my cousin Alaji was already there and I had to follow my cousin Sule, try to build up the story. So this is the beginning of the workshop.
And I think also your attitude in the film changes a little bit. In the beginning, I think you just follow them, but then you also start somehow to try to intervene a little bit more and to try to keep your cousin in the country.
No, at the beginning, it was maybe difficult for me to say, don't go, don't do this, because they said to me, okay, so you had possibilities. You went to school, you had your master in sociology, so you had possibilities. How come you said to us, don't go? We don't have that chance like you have. Okay, but I was like, okay, so maybe I'm going to observe. So all I can do is reflecting to them the reality. Say, okay, you want to go, okay, this is your choice, but this is the reality. And then in the meantime, I had a strong talk with Sule, and I was trying to convince him that there are ways in Dakar. Like he had his small work, he could have stayed in Dakar and tried something. When I found him in Morocco, it was already a year he was there. And I was like, you see, all the time you have been here, maybe you can try. If you stayed in Dakar, maybe you could develop something. But, you know, unfortunately, he was already, he had his idea, he was determined. But it was also interesting for me to show in this film the different perspective of migrant. Like, I'm from a fishing island. For them, migrated, what does it mean? It's like, what do you call it, de passage. Like all the young boys, they want to go above the sea. This is a way to show themselves that they are men. They're going to go to Europe or somewhere else and keep their values and succeed and come back. So I mean, this is another perspective of migration that we should show. And I always wanted also to show not always sad stories, like all we know about, you know, all the film we're seeing about migration, about Africa in general. I wanted also to show them like human beings, like normal human beings who have their dreams and who try to fulfill their dreams. Because basically, I would say traveling is a right for everybody. Is a right for everybody. And also in the background, show maybe the system that create this. I mean, we are fishermen from my island, and all this politic around fishing created this. Like, no more fish, and people start going away looking for something else. So I would love to show them that the price, my conviction is like, you should not get lost your life just to do this. This is my conviction, but at the same time, I cannot tell them what they have to do. And I'm doing documentary, I should just reflect the reality and how the reality is complex. That was the idea.
Yes, what was also a little bit new for me that, often the parents are the one, or the parents of the family are the one that push the sons to go to Europe. And in this case, it was a little bit diverse because he was the one who was so much, he was strongly in his will to go to Europe, and the parents tried to keep him. Although And yeah, okay. In the end, we see that they are also proud, of course, that he has made it. But
yes, it's also in the sense of the passage. I mean, my uncle himself went to Europe when he was young. He stayed here. He discovered the world, and he decided to come back. He would not push his kids to tell them go, but if they really decided, okay, he will let them experiment themselves and know by themselves. But I mean, in the village, the parents are not pushing anyone. They're not pushing anyone. The kids, the brothers are really convinced, they're determined, and they want to do it. So just support them. And what is interesting is to see how the different members of the family are supporting. Okay, they cannot push you, but now you are going. Okay, so we can help you. We can help you. It's like make prayers for you. We can help you. It's like looking for your wife when you're not here. And then they're not pushing, asking for money, because they know what is happening. They know what is happening. And most of the time also, my uncle also took care of all the money they were sending. He can build a good house for them. So when they come back, they know that all the efforts and all the pain they have, this is the fruit. So we saw some other cases in Senegal, like people are away, they send money, and then they don't know what is happening by. Okay? Thank you. Yes. You have a question?
I have a question. She has a question.
She was like...
First of all, thank you very much to have you here. My English is not so good. I'm Serer. I came from Sokon, Njokonjal.
Njokonjal, pa.
So I came from Sokon. We came from the same region. I'm very happy to see you here. My question is, do you have any chance to show this film in Senegal to sensibilize the authorities in Westville, for example?
Yes, thank you. I had the chance to show this film just before I came. I showed it at the Goethe Institute. I showed it the French version. I showed it at the Raw Material, and I'm planning some other shows. So yes, for me, it makes sense when I show it to Senegalese people, and when I bring it back to my village. And this is my plan when I just return.
But you can thank you very much.
Experience the critics.
Yes, people were really. How they receive it. The people were really, first of all, they were really, they appreciate the fact that we are talking about migrants not in the same way. But they ask also one question. It's like, Salu, are you not promoting or are you not doing propaganda, pushing the young to go? I said, why? They said, because you show an example where they have succeeded and they build a big house. That was one of the critics, the strong critics I received. And I said to them, okay, my role is not to modify or to manipulate the reality. I'm doing film and I'm trying to be honest. My role was to show the reality, how it is complex. I have my opinion, which is that migration is not, this kind of migration is not the solution. But at the same time, I respect all this effort and I have to show the reality, which is like, they know that it's difficult. They know that Europe is not paradise. They know all the effort they have to, they know the pain, but they still decided to go. So they say to me, you know, if I stay in Senegal all this time, I would not have built this house. So I'm in Europe and I can do this. So this is sad, but this is the reality. So my role is also to show the reality. And this is documentary film. I'm not doing fiction, right?
Okay, thank you very much, Salu. But I think I will not speak in English because I'm not as fluent as yours. So I will speak in German. Danke schön für diesen Film und danke an meine Freunde, die viele heute hier sind, die ich eingeladen habe und habe gesagt, ich interveniere auch in diesem Film und das war nicht der Fall. Aber ich fand das wichtig und interessant, wie das dargestellt wurde und für das erste Mal sieht man da hinter diese Migrantinnen Menschen dahinter stehen mit Lebensprojekte, mit Lebensvorstellungen und das ist nicht nur Leute, die hier kommen und als in Statistik als Ziffern, sondern da sind Leben, da sind Human Beings und so muss man das auch irgendwie sehen. Was wir noch vielleicht, wenn du jetzt zurückgehst, vielleicht ein bisschen zu zeigen, wie ist das mit diesen Frauen, die da geblieben sind? Wie ist das mit diesen Kindern? Wie erleben die ihre Liebe? Und wir wissen, wie das wichtig ist, ihre Emotionen. Das kommt nicht hier rüber, aber das wäre schön zu sehen, wie es da
für die Frauenseite auch da ist. Aber diese ganze Politik mit da, es gibt eine andere Filme, in dem wir das deutlich dargestellt haben. Und
dieser Aspekt mit den Frauen, der lag uns natürlich auch am Herzen. Und wir haben das diskutiert, aber Alhaji hatte den ausdrücklichen Wunsch. Er möchte nicht, dass wir mit der Frau Aufnahmen machen, bevor er da wieder da war. Das war sein ausdrücklicher Wunsch, das muss man respektieren. Jetzt werden wir es machen.
Ja, super.
Yes, I will just add also, this is the difficulty when you film your family. So where are you going to stop? And there is something important for us is sutura. I don't know how to call it, the sutura. I don't know how to say it in German. Maybe you can help. I don't know. Discretion, like pudeur. Yes. And this is also this was also important for me. Like I'm filming my family, I'm filming my people, but I should not film them like object. You know, I'm not just looking for sensational, for something that European people or some other people would love, but I have to respect the integrity. And I talked to my cousin, who was like, no, I don't want this part in the film, and I respect it. So maybe some other project, we'll talk about those who stayed. Not only the women, but also the boys and those who are trying to build this Africa we want.
Thank you for this film. I understand very well what you just say about pudeur, to take care, to respect. The difficulty is that when you make such a film, you are somehow, you pretend that you can show through what these people are going through. The problem is that the people say it was hard. We didn't see anything what was hard. Yesterday we saw a film just at this place, before coming, you know, at this place up, before they can go through the sea.
Melilla.
Melilla. And we saw during a year how the people fight to come through. It was not a beautiful film. It was moving the whole time. It was bad technically. But it was unbelievable that we could get really a feeling how they feel. What is this initiation about what you are speaking? Initiation in Africa is always going through pain, through hard situation. And the difficulty is, I perfectly understand your objective, not only tell horrible stories, yes, show people like people and not object, respect, but speaking only about difficulties and not giving you any feeling about it, it's difficult. I mean, it is the limit of filmmaking, you know? It's my problem.
Yes, but I mean, people already know how much it's difficult. I mean, it's a choice. He chose to do that. That film, it is his choice. I mean, he chose to show this, it is his choice. I know people love this kind of story. I know. But I chose, yeah, they love action and sensational and pum pum pa and pa. I know what you mean. But I chose not to show that way. Yes. I think people know already how hard it is. There's a lot of film talking about it. And then
it's years.
Yes, and then they forget that these people, by seeing how hard, they forget that they are human beings. And that's the point. And at all, this is just a choice of filming. Some other can do another choice, okay. So this film, this is what I had to share, and I'm really happy for sharing it. Thank you.
Yes, I would like to say that I think this is a very artistic film. It's very, very beautifully made, I think. So somebody said so I don't know. You are always saying, I don't know whose part it is that this is. I mean, this is the conflict too, that artists tend to show beautifully, or even beautifully, the ugly things and the difficult things. I think it's very often a conflict, but I wanted to say that artistically, I think it's very well made.
Thank you.
Thank
you. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Ah. Okay. Oh. But no. Here.
Okay, this one. Okay, I'm Ferdinand Rauwe. I'm from the Netherlands. So I didn't follow the way with the boat. And I have a nautical education. I'm a ship's captain even, and fought for a slavery monument in Middelburg. But come back to your question, or the problem you show that the young boys, they return back to Africa. But I want to address to all European that also the Africans and all the people from the Middle East are also the new Europeans. I know it's hardship, the door are closed, but actually they are the solution for the new Europe. And it will take years and years to accept that Europe is not white alone and blue eyes. And nothing wrong about it, because I married also a white woman with blue eyes and blonde hair. So, and my children are half caste, but the future of Europe is mixed. And the new Europeans are already here. I know a lot of them are drowning and the doors are closed and it's very difficult for them to come inside. But like it or not, that is the new Europe. And some will return back to Africa and build up Africa. That is also good, but there must be also a place for these youngsters in Europe, because that is the future. And if we like to close it with Mr. Wilders in the Netherlands or whoever country, we want to close, I'm sorry, you cannot stop it. It will continue. And the new Europeans are already inside. You can close the doors, but they're already inside. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you.
I have two questions. One question is the question of work in Spain. Was there also a question of racism, that people didn't want to employ them? This was not so clear just in the film, because so often they just said, yeah, we don't have work, or was it really the economic situation?
I mean, the racism was much less than I expected it.
Okay.
Really.
Okay.
We saw when Alaji, for example, was asking for work, the guy for the fishing manager with the boat, I saw the others, the Spanish standing behind, who were searching for work too.
Okay.
And they didn't have any chance.
Okay.
And even in the, I see also, in I was in the plantations for legumes, for the vegetable and these things, and it was also similar, the Spanish workers who were the employed ones. These are the black workers, no? I mean black.
Yeah. Okay.
And they were suffering from the situation they talked about, our supermarkets who pressed them and things like that. So you see, this is a whole system.
Okay.
And it is not only built on racism, it is a social system.
Okay. Economy. Thank you very much. And the second question was, the father in Neodor said that there was so many migrants and now things were going on. Was this only the migrants which were abroad, or are there other groups from other parts of the country are coming now to build, to find work in the...
No. It's mainly the migrants from the village, who moved from the village, went to Europe.
Okay, it was mainly just because they sent money.
Yes.
Yeah, okay, this was just, okay.
I'm back again. Okay, my second question is, Morocco, you know the relationship between Morocco and Senegal. Okay, I don't have to go back through this. Now, I saw last week the king of Morocco telling to the whole world that he's back home. And I see how my people are suffering in Morocco. Do you have any intention to inform the government? You know, I know you can do it.
Yes. Yes, this is really important, because one of the slap...
I would like to give the microphone to my sister, Dr. Mariam, that she say this in German, because my German is not so good. Please.
Ja, er will, dass ich das übersetze. Er hat gesagt, der König von Marokko hat letzte Woche gesagt, ich bin zurück nach Hause, weil Marokko war seit jetzt über 30 Jahren nicht mehr Mitglied von Afrikanischer Union. Und dieses Jahr haben die dann, letzte Woche glaube ich, jetzt ist er wieder aufgenommen worden.
Wegen des Sahara, musst du
wegen
sagen.
Wegen des Sahara. Und man weiß auch, welche Rolle die da spielen in Bezug auf Migration und auch die Rolle, die Europa Marokko gegeben hat, dieser Mauer. Aber nur noch dazu, wir sehen auch jetzt, dass in Libyen, weil Libyen ist das eine Stadt. Mit wem kann man da Verträge machen? Mit wem darf man da arbeiten? Aber Europäische Union hat jetzt vor, in Libyen auch Hotspots zu bauen. Das heißt, es wird immer noch schlimmer, wie wir das hatten. Und die Zivilgesellschaft schaut zu. Ich glaube, wir wollen und werden auch diese Art von Filmen nehmen und wirklich eine Plattform binden, um mehr Einfluss zu nehmen über diese ganze Politik, die wir jetzt nur noch im Radius hören und haben keinen Einfluss dazu sagen, wir wollen das nicht. Leute waren bei TTIP auf der Straße. Aber wenn das über Migration so Maßnahmen genommen wird, werden wir nicht schnell auf der Straße gehen. Aber da müssen wir jetzt schon anfangen, weil wenn nicht, dann haben wir mehr Probleme in Zukunft, als wir das lösen können. Dankeschön.
Danke.
Maybe what I would love to add is just like one of the slap I got during this film is my experience in Morocco. Because maybe before I was like, Africa, unite, we all one, and you know. And then when I arrived in Morocco, they said, hey, African man, how are you? I was like, what? So who? What are you? I'm African, so what are you? We are Maghreban. I said, okay, so you're living in Asia? And then, you know, that was one of the slap. And then I realized that it's no more question of race, of place in the world, but it's a question of system. Like there's a system that now capitalism and all what we know, what this system is present in Africa also. So unless we don't really fight to change this global system, we'll always have these consequences. So it's nice we can watch a film, talk, discuss, get ideas, and tomorrow we take the same life we have. How are you going to make change? So maybe what we're trying in Senegal is already talking about what is happening in Morocco, showing this film, doing manifest, trying to protest, because a lot of Senegalese were killed there, and then trying to push, like saying, okay, all the president, Morocco, Senegal, they are friends, but in reality, that's not what we're seeing. So I think we should also all think of the system and how do we fit that system.
More questions?
Okay. Thank you. We do some music.
So thank you. Yes, I just invite you to two or three songs upstairs. Thank you.
Thank you very much.